Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. This is Cap Cowboy here with my good friend Swag. Say hello.
Hey, yo.
We are doing a very special video tonight because we're talking about Swag and we're on Swag's account. So I want to do this video because Swag is a free-to-play player. So you see me as the pay-to-win kind of player, and now we also have Swag as the free-to-play. And if we can see here, we have a Citadel 30 castle. Yeah, that's right. My friend here has the Iron Fortress as a free-to-play player. We are in Kingdom 50, one of the newer kingdoms. He is complete free-to-play player, okay? He's got the Iron Fortress. He's got 4 billion power, which is a lot more power than a lot of our pay-to-win players in our kingdom have. We're a relatively new kingdom. I think we're around like 3 months. Working on like 3.5 right now, I believe.
Yep, right around there.
But he is now ready to go up to Citadel 31. So, I'm taking the honors to go ahead and speed up his upgrade for him against his will. And we're going to go ahead and see his beautiful castle. Oh god, you only have 70 minutes of like free speed ups? It's just terrible.
I know.
I could not readjust to this lifestyle.
Feel free to send me all the VIP.
Yeah, no, I'm not sending you any VIP, bud. And we just collected his Reach Citadel 31 rewards. That is absolutely awesome. Bunch of awesome rewards, but here's the reason why Swag is going up to Citadel 31 rather than putting those resources into his research. So, as a free-to-play, every little bit counts. So, by going up to Citadel level 31, we are now getting better rewards out of our Inferno events. So if we look at the individual rewards that you get for hitting each level, once you get to Citadel 31, now we're getting level 40 gear for free. So in this specific Blood Moon Special Super Inferno event, if he were to complete it, he gets 44 agility material chests. So we're getting a bunch of level 40 gear because he's already maxed out his level 30 gear from the gift box events, but we'll talk more on that in a bit. But yeah, we're getting level 40 gear now for just different events. Our random card now has more special rewards. It does get more expensive, but again, like with the events, that takes more points to unlock those higher levels, but you're getting better rewards. Those are rewards that you can't get as a Citadel level 30. So let's go ahead, we'll do a little bit of Q&A. And we'll just, you know, see how, what are the tips that a free-to-play master like Swag can give us and give all of you on how to build up your account to compete with all the pay-to-win players and not spend a single penny to do so. So Swag, what would you do with your random cards in order to maximize your return on investment?
Well, on a daily basis, I only flip random cards until I get the jackpots, and I specifically try to avoid any of the jackpots that give runes, as you can get runes very, very easily when it comes to Blood Moon, so I don't worry about runes whatsoever. I get all of the speed-ups and the resources for each page of random cards. I flip the page until I can't flip page anymore every single day.
Alright, perfect. So we see you're saving a lot of coins now because at a level 30, it's only 50 coins, ancient coins, per flip. Now at level 31, it's up to 100. So because of that reason, you only want to flip until you get the 3 special rare rewards, and it's going to save you a lot in the process. Now, when it comes to events, Swag likes to only go ahead and do the bare minimum for these events to get those rewards. So he hasn't done the Super Inferno for BM because BM is a slaughterhouse, but when it comes to just regular events that come on every hour, he tries to do as many events as possible while sparing as much AP as possible. He saves all of his AP for specific events that he wants to do. BM is how he gets all of his resources. And we're talking Chaotix nonstop during BM. So save up all your AP as possible. Spend all the gold possible that you can on AP because every little bit counts when it comes to Blood Moon and getting a bunch of resources to fund your upgrades for the month. So we're doing that. We're doing the bare minimum on this Inferno and the solo events in order to get all those rewards. Now, when it comes to the rest of the game, okay? Swag, what else do you do that really sets you apart from other free-to-play players and allows you to build up your account?
I save AP every single day. I go to the wishing well. I wish until the AP is 200 gold per wish. I do that every single day.
Except for today.
And I typically don't do any of the monster or chaotic events during the month until Blood Moon. That way I can save up as much AP as possible. Another thing that I do is I try and ensure that I'm doing the weekly kingdom raid every single week. And I try and get, typically I get top 5. There's a lot more people in the kingdom now, so top 10 is acceptable. And that just gives you some extra bonus rewards. Along with, as you were saying before, completing all the events until I have the final reward, but not going beyond it. I'm not really going for rank. I'm just trying to slowly grind up as many materials as possible for the minimum cost. And basically, I take that to the next level with every single thing that I do. So I go and do Battle Royale. I try and do as many Battle Royales as I can, and I don't only do Battle Royale on my account, I'll do Battle Royale on multiple farms. That way I can get a ton of war coins at the end of each month, and I can use that on just a massive, massive amount of resources, which comes in handy when it comes to doing gear and upgrades and things of the sort.
Yeah, so Swag, how many war coins would you say you get from Blood Moon every month?
Battle Royale.
Oh, yeah.
And I get... Sorry. Roughly, it used to be 5,000 for being in the top 1K. Now it's 10,000. But you can get even more. You can get 15 or up to 20,000 per month, and possibly more if you're in the top 20 because you get into a tournament, which will allow you to then gain even more.
Perfect. Now, another thing that Swag really does well is his gear. So there's a ton of different events that he can go ahead and get. For his gear, so let's go ahead and take a look at that. So his gear, he's only rocking really level 30 gear sets, so that's another reason why he wants to move forward into Citadel level 31, is because once you get to Citadel level 31, all of your hourly events are giving level 40 gear chests, and that's all he needs to work on now. And he was able to get all of his level 30 gear so quickly, upgraded to level 15 maxed out on both his captain and his deputy for all of his different heroes, is because of gift boxes as well as the other special
monster.
Yeah, the cake monsters as well. The cake monsters are a better box for the free-to-play players. However, gift boxes are still a great way to grind out some of that level 30 gear that you might be trying to go for. So if you're going for gear and you need gear pretty badly, save your AP for gift boxes. If you're going for resources for some upgrades or research, you need to go for Blood Moon and save your AP for that. So basically, a free-to-play player sums down to, where am I going to save and spend my AP? And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you become the best free-to-play player like Swag right here. Now, I'm sure there's higher power players that are free-to-play than Swag, but they're probably in Kingdom 1 or Kingdom 5, and they've been playing the game for an extra 12 months. Over what Swag has been playing this game. So, ladies and gentlemen, go ahead, Swag.
I would just like to throw out there a challenge for anybody playing in any of the new kingdoms. If you're playing free-to-play, I've been around for about 3 months even in my kingdom. We started in our kingdom 17 days late. So you could take K50 and minus 17 days. That's how old my account is. If somebody is playing in one of the newer kingdoms and they've got an awesome free-to-play, I challenge you to beat me in power and castle level, and send in some pictures, and we'll take a look. If you do, maybe we'll spotlight you in a video and show off your awesome gains.
Yeah, so, ladies and gentlemen, no better way to become a best free-to-play player in one of those new kingdoms than joining the Iron Throne playtest. That's what Swag did. It gives him a huge edge over everyone else that is not in the Iron Throne playtest. And there's no better way to do that than by contacting me, figuring out how you can do that so that you can go ahead and get a head start on upgrading your account. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for watching. I did pop up there a Facebook page. I was featured on the Iron Throne Facebook page. There's a little bit of Q&A on my own personal account. So if you want to see a pay-to-win kind of a deal, which also has some advice for the free-to-play players, as well as just some general account upkeep, go ahead and take a look at that. The link will be in the description of this video. And if you want to join that Iron Throne playtest that I just mentioned and get a head start, just like Swag did, and be an awesome free-to-play player, or even pay-to-win player, because that's how good the Iron Throne playtest is. Hit me up in any of the ways listed below in this video. Thank you all for watching. This is Captain Cowboy, signing off. And thank you, Swag, for your generous gift of allowing us to upgrade your castle. It's level 31.
Anytime, brother man. Thank you.
See ya.